they represent Tech's finest, and we appreciate their attendance tonight, we would like to recognize them and thank them for their commitment to scholarship and their devotion to character with a round of applause. This induction ceremony provides recognition to students who have excelled academically and congratulates them on their achievements. Most importantly, it is an opportunity to welcome our new members into Tech NHS. 35 new members will be accepted into the society tonight, and each student was first invited because he or she has a cumulative GPA of 3.8 or higher. Each student then completed an application documenting 10 to 20 hours of community service in the past year, as well as at least one activity in which they held a leadership position. The faculty council then reviewed all student applications. The students here tonight were selected to become members of the National Honor Society, an honor and tradition dating all the way back to 1927. At this time, I would like to invite our principal, Mr. Harris, to speak on behalf of Tech staff and administration. Over the past 3 years, Mr. Harris has tackled a myriad of issues never before seen, all while demonstrating Tech's values of pride, respect, and responsibility. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to our principal, Mr. Harris.
Let's give it up for all of the NHS inductees. Let's give it up for them. Good evening and welcome as we honor our Tech 2223 National Honor Society inductees. Tonight, we pay tribute to our scholars who have maintained a GPA of 3.8 and above and have demonstrated academic excellence, leadership, service, and tiger pride. At this moment, scholars, you're reaping the benefits of all your hard work and dedication towards your education. I know this hasn't been an easy journey overcoming the challenges of COVID-19 pandemic, but belief in yourself, determination, resiliency has gotten you to this point of academic excellence. You should be proud of yourself, be proud of this moment, as I know your parents and guardians and family members are all proud of you, along with our Tech learning community. The beautiful thing about learning is no one can take it away from you. I'll share one of my favorite quotes. Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. Nelson Mandela. Enjoy this celebration with your family and friends because tonight we cherish and honor your accomplishment. Have a great evening. Let's give it up for these honorees again.
Thank you, Mr. Harris, for being with us this evening. Now, I will ask the officers to describe to you the four pillars or qualities which are held in high esteem by the National Honor Society, the four pillars that guide membership in this national organization. Ella will begin with scholarship.
Scholarship means a commitment to learning. A great student is willing to spend hours in reading and study, knowing the lasting benefits of a cultivated mind. True scholars continue to learn even when formal education has ended, for education only ends with the end of life. Knowledge is one great element in the pursuit of success, and it can be acquired in only one way, through diligence and effort. Students here tonight know the price and the reward of the acquisition of knowledge. Now Gavin will describe the pillar of character.
Character is the force within each individual which distinguishes that person from others. It gives us individuality and enables self-confidence. Character develops steadily and guides one through life. Character is achieved and not received. It involves striving every day to make the right choices by demonstrating respect, responsibility, trustworthiness, fairness, caring, and citizenship. NHS members hope to prove by example that we value character. Abby will be next to explain leadership qualities.
Leadership influences an entire school. In taking the initiative in class and school activities, the real leader strives to train and aid others to attain the same objective. The price of leadership is sacrifice, the willingness to yield one's personal interest for the interests of others. A leader has self-confidence and will go forward when others hesitate. always needed. Thus, NHS strives to develop leadership in its members. I'll now continue by defining the service criteria. Service can be described in various ways. Within an average day, numerous opportunities to help others will arise. Willingness to work for the benefit of those in need without monetary compensation or that recognition is the quality we seek in NHS membership. Occasionally, the idea of youth as real contributors in society is dismissed. But in reality, student volunteers have a great impact on their schools and communities and play a lead role in creating change. Through volunteerism, NHS members here today are developing habits for continued service into adulthood. I can confidently speak for us all when I say we are committed to the idea of volunteering our time and abilities to the creation of a better tomorrow. Thank you, officers. The national organization's main goal is to recognize scholastic achievement and promote academic excellence. In addition to following the national goal, our school's goal is to utilize student leadership and student engagement to better our school and community. Some of the ways we do this are annual blood drives and food drives, peer tutoring, monthly donation drives, cooperation with agencies such as Salvation Army, Catholic Charities, Country Manor, Meals on Wheels, and the Cancer Society, and elementary school and community outreach events. We also do a small amount of fundraising to support a student-chosen community project or donation. All NHS members here tonight are invited and expected to continue both their level of academic achievement and their service to our school and the St. Cloud community. I would now like to have our Vice President, Ella, introduce our speaker for the evening.
I am now honored to introduce Ms. Blissenbach. It is hard to put into words what an amazing teacher she is for each of her students. For those of you who do not know her, Ms. Blissenbach has been a math teacher at Tech for 19 years. She is kind and caring and manages to get so many students to enjoy math. She finds a way to make class interesting and engaging, like letting us all pick a song to add to our class playlist. She is always willing to listen to us, whether that means talking about our sport or club or complaining about our stressors in our lives. She also reminds us at the beginning of each year how important math is useful in everyday life by calculating the number of taco salads she will be eating for lunch throughout the school year. That number, by the way, is 163. I am glad to have Ms. Blissenbach as a teacher, and I hope everyone has had the chance to be in her class or even just have the privilege to have a conversation with her. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to Ms. Blissenbach.
That was really nice. First, welcome to family and friends for attending tonight. Thank you to Ms. Fenstead for putting everything together. I'm not sure if I should thank our current NHS officers for selecting me as staff speaker because I am fairly terrified right now, but I do appreciate the honor. I have a special place in my heart for this class of 2023, and I'm really looking forward to getting to know the class of 2024 better this year. At the beginning of the school year, I share a graph with my classes showing that for a high percentage of students, math is their favorite subject. However, on that same graph, it also shows that for many, math is their most hated subject. I then tell them that I don't need them to be a math lover. I just want them to be willing to work hard and meet the challenge. Whether this room is full of math lovers or math haters, I'm 100% confident that our National Honor Society students are more than willing to put in the effort to tackle challenges. Current and soon to be newly inducted National Honor Society members, I admire all of you for the work you put into your academics and activities every day. You didn't get here tonight by just showing up. You got here because you care about your learning and your community. You are willing to put in the time and full effort. You are the ones that get 48 out of 50 on your math test, and for some of you are even a little bummed by that, but still want to know what you got wrong so that you can learn from those tiny mistakes. When a teacher or a friend needs help, you are the first to step forward. I see you putting in the time to better yourself and your community. With that level of effort you put into your academics and activities, this is oftentimes paired with stress, pressure, and disappointment when things don't go the way that you want. These feelings are an irritating, natural consequence of caring. I see you when you are being way too hard on yourself. Still, Keep caring and keep stepping up and learning from those mistakes while giving yourself some grace. Be proud of yourself for upholding high standards. Continue to be the positive role models you are for Tech. I am one of many staff members that feel honored to know you and maybe, hopefully, to have taught you something, even if that something is the willingness to persevere when challenged with something you might hate. We care about you and your success too. Thank you for your service to our school and community, and congratulations on this well-deserved honor.
Thank you, Ms. Lissenbach. We appreciate you being here tonight and sharing those kind words with us. Before we continue with the actual induction of our new members, I would like to give the history of Tech's Honor Society and the tradition of past induction ceremonies. Tech is a school that is proud of its traditions and heritage, and the Honor Society has been an impactful part of that past. On April 27, 1927, a charter authorizing a chapter of the National Honor Society here at Tech was granted. In the 1960s, the name was later changed to the Tech Honor Society when membership was based solely on scholarship. In 1996, Technical High School reestablished association with the National Honor Society and the four-pillar criteria-based selection. Tonight, the students inducted will sign their names in the National Honor Society membership book. All Honor Society members back to 1927 have signed their names to the pages of these books. At this time, Gavin will direct the inductees in the NHS pledge. Inductees, please stand.
I will read through the pledge once in its entirety. Then, if you wish to become a member of Tech's National Honor Society, please repeat as a group as I read the pledge a second time, line by line. I pledge myself to uphold the high purposes of the National Honor Society, to which I have been selected. I pledge to do my best to maintain or increase my level of achievement, also striving to develop leadership, to strengthen my character, and to give worthwhile service to my school and community. I pledge myself to uphold the high purposes of the National Honor Society, to which I have been selected. I pledge to do my best to maintain or increase my level of achievement, also striving to develop leadership, to strengthen my character, and to give worthwhile service to my school and my community. You may now be seated. Ella will now instruct you to the next part of the ceremony.
Inductees, as your name is read, please come forward and sign the membership book. Then India will hand you your membership card, and Abby will begin with instructions on stage. Gavin will get us started.
First is Nazra Abdelmasir. Nazra has been designated babysitter at all her family reunions and occasionally helps out at her local mosque. She enjoys hanging out with her siblings and taking photos of nature and wildlife.
Maddie Baker. Maddie plays volleyball and has been on varsity for 3 years. She is captain of the volleyball team and she is in link group. She enjoys spending time with her family and friends.
Sydney Gustin. Sydney has been on the Tech swim and dive team for 6 years, as well as the Tech softball team for 4 years. She enjoys spending time with family and friends.
Faber Gerald Ugu. Faber has been a member of the Tech Knowledge Bowl for 2 years. She recently joined Tech's DECA Club. Faber spends her Fridays with an amazing group of high school students volunteering at the St. Paul Hospital.
Cordelia Grum. Cordy has a unique connection to the deaf community because both her parents are deaf. She She has participated in ASL class since her freshman year and goes to Deaf Community and CODA skating to interact with other ASL students. She also likes to draw and create short stories. She has been involved in Tech's Art Club, where she specialized in clay figurines. She also loves to hang out with the golden retriever, Woodrow.
Natalie Lage. Natalie has been in jazz band for 4 years and has played soccer for 2. Natalie has been on dance team for 3 years and is a captain this year. She enjoys volunteering at Anna Maria's Alliance and hanging out with friends.
Evelyn O'Donnell. This year, it will be Evelyn's 4th year in art club and 1st year in Tech's Chamber Orchestra. Other than cutting her crafts and reading occasionally, Evelyn likes to play bass guitar and draw in her free time.
Zia Munoz. Zia has been in multiple sports and has worked at the Y for 2 years. She enjoys spending her free time with her friends at Tech.
Hugh Tran. Hugh has been volunteering at CentraCare St. Cloud Hospital since July 2022 and has already contributed 100 hours. Hugh works at St. Scholastica to build his resume and to gain experience for future endeavors. He enjoys spending time with his family and hanging out at home. His current future plans are to become a neurosurgeon.
Josie Abel. Josie was in Spanish immersion for 11 years and has played the violin for 10. She is in the Tech Chamber Orchestra and on the tennis team. Outside of school, she enjoys spending time with her friends and family.
Aloha Tayo Ajay. Tayo is a good student. He volunteers at the hospital and is on the varsity math team. He likes to read books in his free time.
Jennifer Amundsen. Jenna is a captain for hockey and lacrosse. She also plays tennis. She likes to hang out with youth practices and spend time with their friends and family.
Charlie Boyd. Charlie has played hockey since he was 3 years old. He also likes fishing and enjoying time up north in his free time.
Abby Brown. Abby has played tennis for 5 years and basketball for 8. She's played in chamber orchestra for 2 years and has been in student council for 3. She enjoys spending time with her friends and family in her free time.
Henry Bertrand. Henry plays soccer, hockey, and baseball for Tech. And when he's not busy with sports, he enjoys hanging out in my neighborhood with his dog.
Avery Doom. Avery has been a member of the Tech swim team for 5 years, as well as club swimming for a total of 6 years. Avery is also a certified lifeguard who has been teaching swimming lessons at Tech.
Claire Gardner. Claire has done competitive gymnastics for 7 years. She enjoys coaching younger gymnasts, spending time with her friends, and being at the lake with her family.
Tegan Gansett. Tegan has played varsity soccer, has run track, and has been a part of the Tech band and choir for 3 years. He takes pride in teaching young soccer players in his local club, CMYSA, for which he has played since the age of 6. Tegan has also been a part of the Spanish Immersion Program since kindergarten. He often volunteers for his parish, the Newman Center, and enjoys walking his 2 huskies.
Winnie Gerald Boo. Winnie is a 15-year-old junior and has been student council for 2 years, link group for 1 year, and equity team for 2 years. She enjoys volunteering at the library and writing argumentative essays. She just became a member of the DECA and is planning to join the debate team.
Julian Grammer. Julian has played volleyball for 3 years and is is a loop reeler. She enjoys hanging out with her friends, family, and her dog, Brenna.
Elise Helsman. Elise is involved in basketball and softball and manages volleyball. In her free time, she likes to hang out with friends and listen to new music.
Amber Kruger. Amber is very focused on her academics and strives to do her best. Amber loves to volunteer at the Humane Society and spend time at home with her dog.
Finnick Mackey. Finnick has been in multiple activities throughout her high school career, which include Tech GSA, Tech Theater, and now the National Honor Society. They enjoy studying hard and cuddling with their cats.
Kirsten Nelson. Kirsten has been a part of the Tech swim team for 5 years and has swam competitively for 10. She enjoys spending time with her family and friends, especially in and around the water. Kirsten is passionate about helping others and shows her love for the water by teaching swimming lessons.
Bailey Noble. Bailey has been dancing for 12 years and is a member of the Varsity St. Cloud Crush dance team. She enjoys volunteering for the school district and loves spending time with her friends and dog, Chips.
Jack Ogre. Jack takes pride in his many hobbies, from jewelry making to axe throwing, but also enjoys spending time with his family and friends.
Kylie Othell. Kylie has been playing lacrosse for 2 years now on the Crush lacrosse team. She is also a part of Linkford. She enjoys volunteering in her free time with the St. Cloud Youth Lacrosse Association and hanging out with her large family.
Ella Rover. Ella has played volleyball for 6 years, has been in speech for 3, and student council for 2. In her free time, she enjoys hanging out with friends, family, and her dog, Milo.
Stella Rush. Stella has been in cross country and track for 5 years and Nordic skiing for 4 years. She's awfully hard to catch, but when she wants to slow down, she enjoys hanging out with her friends and family.
Caitlin Sires. Caitlin has been competitively swimming for 8 years, 5 of those years on the Tech swim team. She has been working at Blue Line for over 2 years as a hostess and server. Caitlin enjoys spending time with her friends and family, especially during the summer.
Raina Volker. Raina has been playing varsity soccer and track for the past 3 years. In her free time, she enjoys going to her cabin and hanging out with her friends.
Alex Walk. Alex is in band, orchestra, cross country, and Nordic skiing. On behalf of the faculty and student body of Technical High School, I hereby accept you as candidates for our chapter of the National Honor Society. As honor students, I impress upon you your responsibility to fulfill our purpose of maintaining excellence in your academic work. In
In addition, I hope you will serve as examples of leadership, good character, and service in our school and the community. Let us now all recognize these new members with a round of applause. Members are expected to attend monthly meetings and participate in school and volunteer activities. Notification of these meetings will be posted on Schoology and we'll receive messages of all the meetings and activities throughout the year by our mind. Our next meeting is a donut breakfast on October 11th. If you are not yet on NHS Remind, Instagram, and the Schoology group, please sign up tonight to receive important NHS messages. I would like to say to our new members, their families, and friends, I hope this has been a memorable time to honor the academic achievement of our students here at Tech. Tech remains a school full of strong high achievers and Tiger pride. This concludes our 2022-2023 Tech National Honor Society induction ceremony. The ceremony was recorded, so if you wish to share with family members, that link will be shared through Schoology as well as on the district webpage. Members, parents, and families, thank you for attending this event. At this time, we ask you to all please exit and head to the cafeteria for refreshments.